for you to pop the tab. That's how it is for me. I timed it with my stopwatch. 9 minutes and 36 seconds, I stood still. It was excruciating. I'm like, I can't take it, man. And there's all these cars looking at you. And there's a belt going in and a belt going out. And so I stood there like furniture, like a stuffed woolly mammoth, like, this is wrong, this is wrong. And we get to the other end, and we go into the crying room. And the crying room is this massive room that holds this rather beautiful statue of Kim Il-sung, the great leader. And Kim Il-sung, they don't have God in North Korea, they have Kim Il-sung, who apparently invented agriculture, the solar system, water, corn, dirt, and everything else. And so inside this room is this large statue of the great leader with this beautiful light show going on behind him. And this woman standing in front of the statue with her hands folded in front of her. And Kim explains to me that she is going to tell us the great story of the great leader. And I've read the rap about this. She's going to cry, and out of respect, we too are supposed to cry. And so she goes into this beautiful delivery of the life of Kim Il-sung, the great leader, and she starts crying. Like, tears are running down her face. Method acting, I'm sure. And you can't be that inspired after, 80 sets a night. But she keeps doing it every day, I guess. And she does something, some Pavlovian thing, she tears up. And I'm not going to try and imitate her because it makes me sound like some kind of xenophobic racist, but she would use a lot of low-end vibrato, like, it was very dramatic, and she's crying, Spy Chick is crying, Kim is crying, like, he can't do it. And, it leaves me cold. I mean, A, I can't understand it. B, I can't cry for a man who starved half of his country's people to death. No way. So she comes to the end of it, and she's looking right at me with the tears drying on her face. And I don't know what to do. I said, Kim, should I tip her? I mean, what do I do? He says, no, just say thank you. And I'm always looking for humor in any situation, because, life without humor. And so how do I thank her and keep myself awake with inherent laughter? Because you can't make it. There's no humor that's going to work with Kim and Spy Chick. So I went up to her and went, oh, thank you. And she's like, anyway, but I have to keep it together. And so then we go down this hallway where all of a sudden we're